Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Surabhi and I'm going to review this book today, which is Ocean by Thames and Hudson. And this is one of our favorite books and my personal favorite books, and I'm going to show you inside of it and tell you why we love it. So it is with laser cuts and flaps throughout. So we bought it recently from the Singapore Aquarium and I just couldn't resist this book. You cannot feel it, but you know these all are cuts. Can you feel the waves? You know, that is a level of, can you see, this is, can you see? So these are these small things which are really, really beautiful. So just because they are so delicate, it is not for very little kids. It is for the kids who can handle it very carefully. So maybe 6 to 7 year old. And then I'm going to the details of it. So ocean. So it tells about the different topics of ocean. So like the ocean, the world, which are the oceans? Why do we have oceans? Why sea is salty? The five oceans, very basic things. And then this talks about the layers. So I always wanted to tell my, you know, do Montessori kind of learning. So I wanted to show her practically, you know, that sea has different levels. We are the animals live at different levels of the sea, and I was never able to explain to my daughter like what exactly, how do we see it. This is so beautiful. Can you see? It is on the shore, then you lift it up from here. Okay, it talks about the animals on the shore, these all. Then this is 0 to 30 meters, the surface water of the sunlight shown. Then it shows virtual animals on this level, and then it also shows that how the color changes as we go down, because there is no sunlight here, and that's why the color of the sea changes. Can you see how beautiful the book is? And this one, like what all hammerhead shark is there, and then you know swordfish, what is the technical details of it, all these ones. So that way it shows everything, and then it goes to the last where it shows that why these animals, you know, are carnivores. These fishes are really carnivorous. They can there is no plants on the bottom because there is no sunlight, and all those details it talk about. So that's one thing it talks. Second topic is talks about the water cycle. Again, very practical. The water cycle is still very, you know, easy topic to explain, but still the drawings are very, very beautiful. So if you're doing a Waldorf kind of, you want to draw and everything, then it talks about the tide. Now again, this was a very confusing topic for my daughter, that why do tide happen, what happens, because we were trying to, you know, we don't live just near the sea. So we will try to go in a high tide, try to go on a low tide, try to show them, you know, that when it's a high tide, water is at this level, when it's a low tide, water at this level. So just, you know, it explains very clearly why we have tides, and then inside, then during tide, these seashells open, all these can open, you know, all these things. So beautiful ones. Talks about the, you know, technical details of sea snails, clams, everything basically, you know, all the technical parts which I think a 7-8 year old should know. And then see again a beautiful cutout where we are talking about wave. Again, I could not explain what is wave and what is tide technically, but then it tells you everything. Why do we get wave? Technical, what is the reason of it? The wave is because of wind, and the tide is because of the motion of earth. So this is the book which is like a blessing to me, where I can read, where I can give her to read and fix it, because we don't do any screen and all. So amazing. Then it talks about the corals. Again, we love corals because of Singapore Sea Aquarium has beautiful corals. So this talk about corals, they are living, non-living, and this also is a cutout here that is a coral polyp. So it is not very wordy also, you know, it's not like too much technical, but very basic introduction kind of thing. And because it is so beautiful, look at this coral leaves, what is the use, why they are, you know, getting extinct, why do we need it, how do we figure out how the coral leaf feed the animals, what kind of animals depend on coral leaf for their food, what is it as a habitat. Then again, very important topic of food chain. So see, this is a cutout, it shows you that's from sunlight, it goes here, then it goes here, it goes here, who is in the top of the food chain. All these things, I mean, they cannot be a better representation of a food chain in my view. And then it's going, staying safe, like what is, you know, predators, how they protect themselves. Every sea organism has its own defending mechanism God has given, all those things. Then the giant squid, that's the main topic, and this was something which my girl was fascinated with, considering the size. It seems the eye of the squid is the size of our head. I mean, we are just bombarded with all the information my daughter is reading. then black smokers, many, many, all, and you see every topic has only one page to it. So amazing. I mean, and then, you know, let there be light. So they are the animals, or the aquatic animals who live at the bottom, and they are specific. They are not like normal marine animals. They are very, very different from the animals which you see in upper zone, and why they are different, how do they survive, what is their mechanism. Then we are going to polar oceans, where we talk about penguins, we talk about polar bears, and again all these are cutouts. So see, so definitely it's not for very young kids, but like that, it shows each thing in so beautiful and pictorial way. Then what are the, we are doing, we are destroying the nature, pollution, corals are dying, icebergs are melting. So that's why we started a discussion. My girl was asking what is iceberg, and then we tried about Titanic and all those things, and that's how it is. So we love this book, considering it, the information it gives and the beautiful cutout it has. So hope you enjoy the book too. Bye bye.